Bill Browder is a man who is very definitely not welcome in Russia unless behind bars. He's been sentenced to 9 years on charges of tax evasion, which he denies. He was the business partner of Sergei Magnitsky, whose unexplained death in police custody in Russia has led to a series of diplomatic incidents with the West. Mr. Browder has a list of 60 Russian officials he holds in some way responsible for the death. Today, a British judge threw out a case for libel by one of them brought in this country. Tim Huell has been covering the case from the start.
A mysterious death in a Moscow jail that 4 years on has done much to poison relations between Russia and the West. Sergei Magnitsky's final hours within these walls were later traced by Newsnight. He was suffering from acute pancreatitis after being allegedly denied medical care and beaten by warders. But he wasn't a rights campaigner, he was a tax lawyer, jailed after he exposed a fraud worth $230 million that he said involved police and other state officials. Magnitsky's employer, the London-based investment fund boss William Browder, claimed the lawyer was jailed and then killed to cover up the scam. He campaigned for a bill, now passed into law, banning Russian officials involved in Magnitsky's arrest and death from entering the United States. That plainly infuriated President Putin. In response, Russia has imposed similar sanctions on some American officials, and this year it tried Magnitsky posthumously and Browder in absentia and convicted them of tax evasion.
Major Pavel Karpov.
But Browder's online campaign against the Russian state continues, with this police officer accused.
The same officers arrested, tortured, and eventually killed Sergei to hide their crime.
Pavel Karpov, on the so-called Magnitsky list of those banned from entering the US, denies the charges and sued Browder and his company, Hermitage Capital, for libel in London.
It's one thing to allege that the police officer, Pavel Karpov, was part of a massive tax fraud, another to suggest that he was directly involved in the torture and murder of the whistleblower Sergei Magnitsky. The judge ruled today that the Hermitage companies had not come close to providing sufficient evidence for that. But the case turned on another issue, the justification for hearing the claim in an English court. Karpov's team argued that it wasn't libel tourism because his accusers are based in the UK. The judge disagreed.
He said the claimant's connection with this country is exiguous. And although he can point to the continuing publication in this country, there is a degree of artificiality about his seeking to protect his reputation in this country.
Today's judgment sends out the message that the British courts will no longer be used or abused to stifle, halt freedom of speech, that officials from any countries, around the world cannot come to the UK and a sort of libel tourism.
The so-called investigators lock people up in here.
But as highlighted in this play about Magnitsky, many questions remain about his case. The Kremlin's reaction to his allegations has served only to put the whole Russian state in the dock. But that state seems determined to seek revenge on its accusers, above all on William Browder.
Well, joining me now is Bill Browder, the hedge fund boss who employed Sergei Magnitsky as his lawyer. It wasn't a great day in court for you today, was it? Because the judge said that simply you did not have the evidence against Pavel Karpov.
I view it as a fantastic day in court today because the judge kicked out a case of, a vexatious case of libel tourism where this guy shouldn't have been suing us in the first place here.
But he did make it clear that he didn't think that you had the evidence that you needed.
Well, so it comes down to a very simple paragraph in the judgment. The judge said we couldn't prove that Pavel Karpov was the guy who beat Sergei. And we never said he was the guy who beat Sergei. We said that he was a member of a criminal group that was involved in Sergei Magnitsky's death. And the judge did say in his ruling that if this had gone to court, he would have allowed us to resubmit our claim to say that he was a member of a criminal group.
Well, you have questions over however Pavlov can actually afford this libel, a retired police officer.
So let's look at this. Let's take a step back. Here you have a police officer. He earns $6,000 a year as a police officer, and he's gone out and hired the most expensive libel QC and solicitor in the country, costing millions, to sue people, and I was one of his victims, as well as many others, to sue his victims in a foreign country. How is that?
But it kind of shows in one way, if you're right, that the Russians will not let this lie. And indeed, they won't let this lie because they want you extradited and to serve 9 years on a charge, or not even on a charge, on a conviction of tax evasion. You can't travel to Sweden, for example, can you? Because you're too worried about being extradited.
Well, so what's happened is we got the Magnitsky Act passed in America, which imposes visa sanctions and asset freezes on Russian officials who are involved in this case and many other cases. The Russian government got furious. And so what they did was they convicted Sergei posthumously in the first ever posthumous trial in the history of Russia. And I was his co-defendant, and they convicted me for 9 years.
You've also death threats, haven't you?
I've got death threats, I've got libel suits, I've got extradition, I've got everything you can think of. The Russians are so completely, I should say Putin, is so completely agitated because we found there's the Achilles heel of this regime, which is they steal money. In this case of Magnitsky, they stole $230 million. A young lawyer exposed it, and then he was killed in prison for exposing it. They steal money, and so we found their Achilles heel, which is let's make sure that money is frozen in the West, and that's what makes Putin so absolutely terrified.
But is there a sense in which you are pursuing this because you feel some responsibility for your colleague's death?
Of course. If he hadn't been my lawyer, he'd be alive, and that weight sits on my shoulders every day. And that's what drives me every day to try to get justice for this man.
And to what extent will you go to get that justice?
I'll go right to the end.
If it means having even to go to Russia, you can't even go to Russia. Would you ever do something that would put yourself in danger?
Well, the only way I'm going to get justice is if I stay out of prison and I stay alive. And so I'm going to try to stay alive and stay out of prison. But I'm going to keep on fighting this, and I'm going to keep on doing whatever I have to do to make sure that the people who killed Sergei Magnitsky face justice.
Bill Browder, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
What makes art